Leo. Okay, hey, this is a Swedish Guitar Nerd, and I'm at a very special place. I'm in the big city of Löddeköpinge, in the south of Sweden, with these guys. Are we in the frame, all of us? Okay, so here's
Jesper. Hello.
And here's
Jonas.
And you're from?
You say
well,
it.
Well, we're from Saxtorp.
Saxtorp.
In Skåne, which is roughly 1.5...
15 kilometers from Copenhagen, if we have wings and fly over the Strait of Öresund. But we are 10 kilometers from Saxtorp now, because we are in Löddeköpinge.
Lucy's Diner. What brings us here, then?
Well, first of all, we would like to show you our showroom, since we are following you on YouTube, and you are a very talented guitar player. So we thought that we are going to demonstrate the Greenchild amps, the K1818 and the G77. And since me and Jonas are not so talented, we thought that, well, leave it to the pros. Oh. So, that's why you are here.
Bad choice. But, okay, I want to know more about the thing you're doing here, or even Guitar Rehab.
There is an interesting story
here.
How
did it start?
Yes. I was just going out of my midlife crisis.
We've all been there.
Yeah, we all been there. And it's fantastic. You get out and you are a better person and all that.
Yeah. Hopefully.
And I got to know Jesper. That's a long story. I won't take it.
Okay,
but
so
anyway,
you're not old friends?
Well, 4 or 5 years.
Okay,
yeah.
Really?
Okay. I
thought you went back to school like pre-school.
No,
thank God. Okay. No.
So I helped Jesper's wife to find a nice cottage in the forest in Saxtorp. And I got to know this fella because it seemed like he was interested in the guitars, and I hadn't played guitars for quite a long time. I would do like you, just stopped it, and I said, I'll just listen to music because I can't create music. And he had just bought the green
the
Telecaster.
Yeah.
And he said, try it.
Yeah.
And I, okay, he's very convincing, I better play a little bit. And he was, oh God, you're good! How do you do that? What the hell? I mean, this is the only thing I can do. And he was doing some films on YouTube, so we decided to do...
I love myself.
Yeah.
I should mention this before you go on. These guys have a YouTube channel, of course. You should check it out. I will leave a link below. Check it out. It's awesome. I really recommend it.
It's a big ego trip.
Yeah, so what is my challenge?
Okay. So the first video Jesper did with me, I was
I dressed
out
him
of
out.
A depression. I was on the way out of a depression.
Had you watched his videos before? Did you know what
you
were getting into?
I didn't know what I was getting into, but I didn't give a shit. I was some antidepressant and all that stuff. Yeah, okay. Take this guitar, okay. Yep. Put this silly hat on, okay, do whatever you want.
And sunglasses.
And you do playback for Sultans of Swing. I think the video is still there.
Yeah, it
really looks so fucking stupid, and I'm playing. And that was a start. And we went to a guitar net, and I bought my guitar, because I got to have some hobby. I got to have life again. And that was when we said, let's have this guitar.
Yeah, let's make
rehab.
Some videos.
Okay,
so together. Play guitar to rehab yourself.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, that's the concept.
Yes.
I was wondering about that. Okay, that's the idea. So, okay.
So, thank you, Jesper, for taking me out of my depression. And thank you, Anders Axelsson and Green Guitar, for taking me out of the depression. I feel so good now. Very much feels. Hang on. Yeah, okay. Yeah, so that's
the start of it. Yeah, so did you buy a green guitar?
Yes, I bought the green...
the special edition.
Telecaster. Yeah.
Okay.
Made in China.
Yeah.
The only they had. Just my colleague saying goodbye.
Okay.
Yep.
So
and I believe we did.
But did you have you didn't have any connection with Anders at Guitarnet back then?
No, not in that.
The guy that's behind the green guitars or
not as much as we have now.
Okay.
I was just an enthusiast who had just bought a guitar, and buying something from the internet could be bad, mm-hmm. and it could be very good, or even
bad or even worse.
Yeah. So I've owned an Epiphone, a Les Paul Junior style, mm-hmm. which was crap, mm-hmm. and I always wanted a Les Paul. Couldn't afford a Gibson, and I saw on Blocket an advertise of Green Guitars.
Yeah, that's how I found out the Green Guitar as well. Yep.
So
the
Blocket
is basically the
eBay.
Yeah. So I took a dive and I ordered. And when it arrived, I was amazed of the build quality and how it sounded. Mm-hmm. So that's how I got into it. And then I jumped on that train over there and infected him. And infected him with my guitar enthusiasm of the green era. Because it's Swedish. It is. Even though it's made in South Korea, it's still, we have designed it and we have, you know. So I thought, be proud,
look at that. It. Green guitars, made by Sweden, with the Volvos.
Maybe since we could do just like a spin around the room just to see your...
You know, we don't have the honorable brands anymore, like Hagström, Levin, stuff like that. They've all been outsourced or stuff like that. Yep. I mean, Hagström are made both in China and in Czechoslovakia, I believe. If you pay more money, it's Czechoslovakia.
I don't think they're making it anymore in Czechoslovakia. Now it's
maybe. So I thought that, why not? Okay, I will go for green.
Mm-hmm. Go green.
Go green.
Go green.
Yep. And then it grew to obsessive compulsion behavior, like OCD. when we started doing road trips up to first Smoland Stena and later on Gislaved and playing guitars and thought that why don't share this on our channel.
And so we established a really good contact with Anders because he saw we were enthusiastic, we were doing film, making films.
He thought we were stupid.
but we had our channel.
Why do you like our guitars? Why?
So with time we established a good relation and when the idea came up, like, let's open a showroom, he said, sure, I help you. I
support you.
I borrow you six guitars and the bass. And he helps out us all the time because he has not everybody wants, if they come from Copenhagen or Malmö, they don't have the time to spend 3 hours in the car to get there. So they can just
maybe buy something from the internet, like I did.
They can have a first impression here. They get a hold of
the guitars.
The quality and what it is.
Yes.
Because everything looks good on a photo. Mm.
Yeah.
But then you pick it up and you start playing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe. That's true. I mean, the thing I'm breaking into the video now. The idea of green guitars, because they're really cheap. Because the first thought you get is like, they can't be that good, can they?
No.
Because they're really affordable. Mm. So, yeah.
We were at Guitar Toys in Ystad.
Yes.
They're
based in Stockholm.
They have closed. Based in Stockholm now. And the guy who was there, didn't he try that one? Well, something like that.
Yeah.
And he said, what's the price of this?
No, he didn't try. He tried my Telecaster.
Okay.
Yes.
But then he ordered
another
one. And he said, what's the price of this one? Mm-hmm. And we told him, yeah, but if I'm going to buy it as a customer, well, that's
I'm
the price we're talking about.
Yeah.
Oh, you must be kidding me. So he ordered one straight away.
Yeah.
And that's the fun part, as you were talking earlier about. There are no small music shops around in Sweden any longer.
Oh, at least very few.
So we decided to do some kind of a road trip to say hello and present Green Guitars as a favor for Anders.
Yeah, okay,
So he's a reseller now, or retailer, what do you call it.
Yeah, yeah.
And also we have one, Lars Gren in Copenhagen, with Green Music. And he just loved it because it's his name on the headstock.
I see a theme here.
Yep. But the guy at Toys Music, he said, we sell maybe one electric guitar per 6 months. And when we we visited him a few months later, he had already sold 6 or 10.
Oh, really?
In a time lapse of what? Two months?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Speaks for itself.
That's the story.
That's the story. So, how did the showroom come about? How did you find this place? And I mean, yeah.
I think I have to take that question.
Please do it.
I'm an ancient fish farmer. Very odd job, I know that. All of me is odd. But anyway, I was here selling this vegetarian fish. It's tilapia, whatever it is. But so I got to know Fredrik Hornborn, the owner of
Loses.
And there's another owner, Anders. Yep. I think his name is Anders too. And we had this, we had something called Meat and Strings together with Pete, who's from France. He's a love refugee, fell in love with a blonde Swedish girl. And we had this one occasion with a band, with a guy playing. And Felix thought it was really funny. And then we sat down with him one day, me, Jesper, and we said, well, we also have this dream of having a showroom somewhere with a green guitar so people can try them and see how good they are. And he said, well, I got this old handicap, which is, well, a bathroom for disabled, but it's not in use. You can have it. So here
great.
We are.
There we are.
So behind
sitting
that black box, behind the black box, there's
a toilet.
It's a working toilet.
Yeah. Yep. You can flush it.
So that's, instead of starting up in a garage, as in the dot-com business, we started in an old disabled bathroom. So here we are, and it's been 6 months or something.
No, since December.
December?
Since 4 months.
My God, okay, just 4 months. Feels like longer because we had so many things here. So.
But that's our relationship.
Feels like I've known this guy for 15 years because we've done so many things together.
Yeah, you get the feeling when you see you together. It's like they've known each other for ages. Okay, so you got the room. So what is the concept of the room? Is it just to show guitars? Do you sell the guitars as well? How does that work?
Okay, we could, how do you say that? Förmedla.
Okay, so you can buy guitars from Green.
They come here. They play. Oh, I like that one. Well, visit the homepage and order one because now you know how it feels and sounds.
Okay, so you can't grab one from the wall.
No.
Well, if you have enough money, everything.
Yeah. Okay.
And I have a guitar.
And you tell Anders, well, maybe someone stole it.
I don't know.
It's gone.
So that's the deal. Okay. So that's the deal. It's just for show and for testing and listening, feel.
Yeah. I've seen your videos and I noticed that you actually handpick guitars, or am I right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So what made you decide on these ones?
Jonas?
Well, what I like is to take the models that
are not so famous.
They're not so famous, but still, I mean, you have Elvis with that guitar.
Mm-hmm.
Johnny Winters used to play on that one. The wife, I don't know, but Jesper liked it, so we took
nice.
It. And you have the Gibson Les Paul.
Gibson, yeah.
And we don't have any Fender Stratocaster. And not hanging, we have that one, of course, but it's not in the showroom.
No.
And that's because the Stratocaster is a fantastic guitar, but I think
it's
they,
been
they
copied.
Have, yeah, and they ruined the magic by selling all kinds of shit in the shape of a Stratocaster. So I'm a little bit fed up with the Stratocaster because there's so many bad examples out there. So and everybody is doing. You can buy a Fender Stratocaster at Jula. You know those Grand Surface. What's
at
the name?
Walmart.
Yeah, and it's crap. So let's show the other guitars. Everybody's making a copy of the Fender Stratocaster. It's obligate. How do you say it? It's a must.
Yeah.
So they do it in green, but they also do this. I mean, look at this one, a Telecaster with two
F
holes.
It's like a thin lined.
Mm-hmm. I mean, usually
with
it's just that one.
Yeah,
but they couldn't resist doing another. Mm-hmm. And that's so funny when they make guitars with very small series, and they say, let's make two holes. Yeah, we can make five of them. nobody will complain.
And if that's the thing with green guitars, right? It's not like even 10 of each.
No, it's no mass production. Anders picked the guitar he likes, he would like to own himself. I just get the impression. And one day I was there, I said, I've seen this Telecaster with three mics. Next time we were there, you know, we were talking about the Telecaster with three mics. He's hanging out there. He did it, you know, so you can, the ideas.
It's the Jonas signature model.
No, but it's like they have on their webpage, I don't know if you've seen it, requests of models.
Yeah.
And maybe, okay, we can do it in black or we can try this one and stuff like that. So it feels like it's a company that you are personally involved in, since I can...
You can affect what
the outcome. Yeah. I can make a wish and maybe 2 years later it's in production. So, that's the deal with that.
It's almost like the guitar you first bought, the standard, it's no longer in production.
No.
Okay.
And so it's going to be a rarity.
Yeah.
If it said Fender today, it would be.
It would be twice as much as you bought it.
And the one that I bought, they don't make it anymore. It was a Chinese manufacturer. He was good, because they're very picky with the quality. But they said, now we only want to have a guitar from South Korea. It's simpler that way. So they ended the production of the special edition, which became a limited edition as well.
Okay. So there are different levels of green guitars. So
It's the Comfort Series, which is the basic entry level.
Yep.
And then you have something called the Master Class. Master Series.
Are they still made at the same factory?
Or? No.
Okay, they aren't. Okay.
No. Because I believe that the Master Series and the Custom Shop are made in a very small hand-picked factory. Mm-hmm. So there's a difference both in price and in quality.
Okay. Yeah.
Better pickups. Well, overall, a more decent guitar.
I see. Well, the Comfort Series is really good. I see that, say that for free again. I've tried them, it's really good. It's really impressive what you can do.
And that one is an FGN, Fujigen.
This is a really expensive one.
Yes.
No, it isn't.
No, it's not.
Compared to, if you buy an American Fender, this is really cheap. But this is pro parts made in Japan.
And I believe that Anders at Guitarnet is the only Swedish retailer in Sweden.
Yeah, I think Sweden. It is. Yeah, yeah.
Yep.
FGN. Yes.
Is it Fujigen or just FGN?
FGN, it's on the headstock there. So, I don't know, FGN is there a mark?
I suppose Fujigen is a
brand.
Place in Japan.
Yep.
Yes, it's a mountain, I think.
Oh, really?
Okay. I don't know.
I'll go there soon.
Yeah. And then, so they have like three levels of green, and then they have, after green, you have FGN, and then you have guitar starting at that. This one was 7,000, okay. 700 bucks.
So
and up to
twice as much as a Comfort Series.
Yeah.
And then it's up to 12,000-15,000, I think.
And then they have the Gilmore.
Gilmore.
Handmade. Totally
really
handmade.
Gilmore. See your theme here as well?
Oh, yes.
But that is that Anders brand? That's
no.
Making those
no, that's
Gilmore
a Japanese-based or Korean? Korean-based. Gilmore
is Korean.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what does the future hold for Guitar Rehab? What's the natural step forward?
Learn to play guitar.
You can play guitar.
And hopefully do some collaboration with you, like some live stuff on YouTube.
That would be really
cool. Yeah. And swap out some of these guitars to newer models.
Yeah.
So that's in a close future, I believe.
Okay.
And also for the Guitar Rehab channel, we were discussing yesterday, Jesper, that there are like you have a Guitarnet in Gislaved, not far away in where is that? Well, you have Lundgren pickups, not so far away. You have Sonemu, who does those
relic
guitars.
Yes, yes.
And we have a very good, he makes acoustic guitars, Thomas Fredholm. Okay, if you know him, he's in north of Gothenburg.
Yeah, yeah.
So it would be interesting to
do a road trip,
more road trip, and show Guitar Sweden. See all those enthusiasts.
What Sweden can deliver.
Yes, and trying to stay in the lower third of Sweden, because there is this museum up
in Umeå. Yeah, with those two.
Well, we have more sponsor money. We can do it, but now. My wife wouldn't let me.
But that's like you Gibsons from 59. It's just like it's regular guitars, basically.
So there are to let this Guitar Rehab thing evolve and like marketing Sweden or like should share our passion and with other passionate people and show them the enthusiasts, the nerds.
Yeah,
the first one here. Yeah. So we've got to find more of those creators.
Join forces.
Yes.
Yep.
Nerds against the world.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
So I've heard you started the band as well.
Actually, we did. We are the world's worst rock band. We had a gig.
I accidentally told him about
legendary
it.
12
no,
people
no.
and a little dog. And
no.
they were so drunk they didn't beat the shit out of us. Afterward, we were so fucking bad. But we did the gig.
Yep.
We did the gig,
like true rockers.
First, last and only gig. Three gig in one, you know?
So,
and we will never reunite.
You will now, when you get famous from this video. Everyone will demand it.
Oh my god.
Have you put the film?
Yep.
In the middle of the song, I just
I haven't seen
pick
it,
up a bottle
it
and I start to drink.
Yeah, you will have
very,
to see it.
Yeah.
Maybe there will be a link
not
to
very
that
focused.
Film as well.
Oh,
okay,
my god.
So you won't be opening for Love Bomb soon then?
Don't think so, no. Okay.
We will have to tattoo our blood number in the forehead before and talk to our insurance agent. But
is this doable? No, we can't insure you for this.
This
are you
too
sure?
Dangerous.
Sorry.
Oh.
Okay, but okay, just ending on something. You have a guitar interest, you're a guitar nerd, you were working with Anders. When will the Jesper and Jonas models come? Has there been talks about this?
No.
Wouldn't that be amazing, Anders?
The problem is, should it be Jesper and Jonas model or Jonas and Jesper model? So that's
I think you should have one and you should have
yeah,
one.
Yeah, we should. Jonas model and Jesper
ones.
Model. Yeah.
So. I believe that if you're going to have a signature model or something like that, first of all, you have to be able to play guitar.
Oh.
So let's say 50 years from now, I can do more than E, A, and D. Maybe a G sus.
It's all you need.
It's all you need, the three accords.
Mm-hmm.
But, no, I don't know. No. Maybe. Sounds stupid to even discuss a signature model.
Well,
you're quite hooked on that idea.
Yeah?
Well, they could call it just the crazy motherfuckers model. Signature model.
Short.
Those
CF.
Are
or,
the guys.
Or what is the here, back on the bolt on neck. The guy who couldn't play. Sounds
what,
awful.
What features would it have?
Bad intonation.
It comes with bad intonation. It's impossible to get that.
Four strings. All G strings. One humbucker and one single coil, lots of tremolo with coil tapping, stuff you don't need, a booster control.
And a mug holder.
And a mug holder.
Yeah, that's,
sounds,
that's it.
Sounds doable, doesn't it?
And we will sell it for 2,500 Swedish kronor.
Oh, yeah, oh,
that is including
price,
a gig
price.
Bag.
Okay,
yes,
okay.
And free support.
Maybe something to put in the cup holder, like a free can of Coke or something.
Have
okay,
full.
I'm looking forward to this. I hope Anders is making like, okay, oh yeah,
taking notes.
And cake,
yep.
Four strings. I can see it becoming the big star.
They actually made a model, a Telecaster, you know, the thing that they brought over from South Korea. completely no paint on it.
Okay.
And they treated it with some
nitrocellulose.
No, that was the other one.
Okay.
The one that was so eco.
Yeah, okay.
Linolia.
Okay, yeah.
And it had a special sound, yeah, it's one off, because they are all into environment. It's green, that's why it's an environmental
consultant. It's really worth mentioning. I don't think I made as big of a point in my video about it as I should have, because, I mean, they are climate compensating every single guitar. Mm. Name one guitar company.
And Anders is driving an electrical car, for instance.
So, yeah. And you talked about in one of your latest videos, they're changing the fretboards to something that's more sustainable.
Maple, yes. Yeah. What was it called? Maple rosewood?
Rose.
Fried maple. Fried maple.
I suppose it's maple.
He had to write it down and hold it up. And then I forgot about it again. So, but it's like this CETA's rules. And we were so happy that the TL Rosewood came into America to Nick in the States. Because
just changing.
Because
had they checked it out at the customs, it would have gone back to Sweden, or they would have burnt it or whatever. So,
but that's a good thing. I think it's a good thing.
Yeah.
I mean, you're cutting down the rainforests.
Mm,
for God's sake. Okay, so that's what you're looking for, the new special edition, special model.
We'll have a meeting with Anders, talking serious stuff.
Sounds really like a serious signature
model. Old, ugly, and no talent. Oh. We want to have a signature model.
I think it would be a fun video to actually, I'm trying to be serious here, but okay, to actually make like one of the custom guitars.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Maybe Anders? Okay, we're just giving Anders lots of ideas, and he's like...
For free!
No way, it's not gonna happen.
Mm.
Oh.
Eight pickups.
Eight pickups.
Nine strings.
Oh, nine strings. Get a bass, Meshuga. Okay, well, I think we've said enough for this time. We'll get back here, of course, to see all the new models we bring here. And for that live video thingy...
Yep.
We should probably be sending it from here, shouldn't we?
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Some kind of web. Yeah. Okay, so you see, maybe see us soon. Who knows?
Who knows?
At least separated, but maybe together. Who knows?
Via the internet.
Internets. Okay, so.
Internets.
So it's thank you from the Swedish Guitar Nerd and.
The crazy people from Guitar Rehab.
Guitar Rehab. Okay. See you soon. Bye.
Since Jesper wasn't really happy about the ending on Jonas' part, he's gonna do the ending again. So here it comes.
Okay. Auf Wiedersehen. Hej då. Au revoir. Goodbye. See you again soon.